This lecture discusses the monopoly problem. And we start with a very simple problem. Demand is given by Q equals 11 minus P. The cost structure is C equals 16 plus Q. What is the maximum profit that this monopolist can make? From the demand and cost equation, we can set MR equal MC, and we will obtain the quantity that maximizes profit. Plug that quantity into the demand curve, and we get the price. Multiply that price times the quantity to obtain the revenue. Go to the cost function, plug that quantity into the cost function. Now subtract the total cost from the total revenue, and we have the answer to the question, the maximum profit. From the inverse demand function, P equals 11 minus Q, we obtain the marginal revenue equation, MR equals 11 minus 2Q. From the cost equation, we get marginal cost equals 1. Set an MR equal to MC, we obtain 10 equals 2Q, or Q equals 5, which gives us P equals 11 minus 5 equals 6. So revenue is 5 times 6 equals 30. With the cost equation, C equals 16 plus Q. At Q equals 5, C equals 21. The profit is 30 minus 21 equals 9. We'll now determine the average cost. Divide the total cost by Q, and we obtain AC equals 16 on Q plus 1. So we have average cost equals 1 plus 16 on Q. And we see that as Q increases, the average cost is going to decline. The average cost is always declining towards 1, which happens to be the marginal cost. But you will notice that AC is always going to be greater than MC. We're going to identify two important points where the average cost curve crosses the demand curve. These are known as break-even points, where the price is equal to the average cost. Our challenge then is to find the break-even points by setting P equals AC, or alternatively, revenue equals cost. Of course, it's possible to use a table and determine the average cost for every level of output. So we plug the value of Q into the average cost equation. So we have average cost at Q equals 1 is 17. At Q equals 2, AC equals 1 plus 16 on 2 is 9. At Q equals 4, AC equals 1 plus 16 on 4 equals 5. At Q equals 8, AC equals 1 plus 16 on 8, 1 plus 2 equals 3. And we see the declining average cost. Our two break-even points are going to be at Q equals 2 and Q equals 8. Here is how we determine those break-even points. Break-even requires zero profit, or revenue equal cost, or price equal average cost. 11 minus Q times Q is 11Q minus Q squared. So revenue equals 16 plus Q. If we rewrite that equation, for a positive q squared term, we get q squared minus 10q plus 16 equals 0. The quadratic formula, q equals minus b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a, where a is the coefficient on the q squared term, b is the coefficient on the q term, and c is the constant. Plugging in these values into the equation, we come up with Q equals 2 or Q equals 8 after some manipulation. So here is the graph again. Two break-even points at Q equals 2 and Q equals 8. We're going to obtain P equals 9 and AC equals P equals 3. This helps us to determine that the better value would be P equals 3 at Q equals 8. Notice that in the demand equation, P equals 11 minus 8 is 3. In our average cost equation, AC equals 1 plus 16 on 8, 1 plus 2 equals 3. So we see why P equals AC at Q equals 8. Because the average cost curve is declining continuously. The slope keeps getting flatter. So we say it is asymptotically approaching the marginal cause. Let's look at the values of which we are sure now. At P equals 6, we maximize profit for Q equals 5. Our breakevens are at Q equals 8, at price equals 3. And Q equals 2, price equals 9. It should be obvious that no one would charge a price of 9. If you're trying to break even, you would charge a price of 3 because it makes you look better, a larger quantity, at a lower price. Citizens would appreciate that, and the governments would appreciate the fact that the social welfare value is higher at Q equals 8. But we need to determine where the average cost curve goes on the graph. At P equals 3 or P equals 9, we would choose the lower price because it will deter entry if entry is a real possibility. So we need to determine in this case whether or not entry is a real possibility. Let us lower the fixed cost from 16 to 10 and recalculate the problem. The first thing you should notice is that changing the fixed cost does not affect the MR equals MC outcome because the marginal cost is still 1 and the marginal revenue is exactly what it was. Profit is revenue minus cost. We're going to obtain cost equals 15 at maximum profit, and the revenue is 30, so 30 minus 15 equals 15. We want to sketch the new average cost curve, so I'm going to start with the old average cost curve and try to show you where the new average cost curve will lie. We can use our table here to determine what the average cost would be for fixed cost equals 10. So when Q is equal to 1, 10 over 1 is 10 plus 1 equals 11. At Q equals 2, 10 over 2 is 5 plus 1 equals 6. At Q equals 5, we get 3. At Q equals 10, we get 10 over 10 is 1 plus 1 equals 2. So we see the negatively sloped average cost curve. It is not too difficult to determine the average cost curve, but what is important is whether the new average cost curve lies below the marginal revenue curve at any point. If we are referring to an open source resource where anyone has access to, if this firm is making profits, others will be automatically attracted to the market. So let us determine whether or not it is profitable for a second firm to enter the market. I show you here in this graphical analysis the old industry demand curve, the dotted green line, and I say if there are two firms in the industry, they will share the market, and each will have half of the market. These are assumptions. So the industry MR curve will become the demand curve for each of the two firms. The MR curve for the industry being the demand curve for each of the two firms, the new demand curve will be P equals 11 minus 2Q. So revenue is 11Q minus 2Q squared. Since we want to find the break-even point, we're going to set the profit equal to 0 and solve for Q. Using the quadratic formula, we obtain Q equals 10 over 4 plus the square root of B squared minus 4AC, i.e. the square root of 10 squared minus 4 times 2 times 10, so we have 4 times 20. So we obtain 10 over 4 plus or minus the square root of 100 minus 80 over 4, or square root of 20 over 4. When we solve this equation, we get QI equals 2.5 plus or minus 1.118. Notice the 2.5 is in the middle of the analysis with respect to the curves. So we see that the quantities where MR equals AC would be 3.618. 2 times 3.6 is 7.2. So the price will be 11 minus 7.236, which gives us 3.764. We have now concluded that the average cost curve crosses the MR at P equals 3.764. other firms would leave the industry. This would give the firm the entire market to itself. So when we have two firms that can profitably coexist, the first firm should set the price so that the second firm sees no profits, and the first firm will have the entire market for itself at the lower price. With a decreasing average cost, it will turn out that the firm will make a profit equivalent to the fixed costs of the second firm. So the profit maximizing condition would be pi equals 10, which is our final solution.